Hello all, welcome to my channel Crystallized Science. So today, in this today video, I will welcome you to the last topic of this chapter, last theory topic of chapter 9, that is law of conservation of momentum. Okay, so this law of conservation of momentum is derived or stated through Newton's third law of motion. What was Newton's third law of motion? It was that action and reaction are equal and opposite. So this was Newton's third law of motion. So let's try to derive this law of conservation of momentum. So for this, I have taken the diagram from textbook that is given. See, there are two balls with mass ma and mass mb. Okay, these two balls have its own initial velocity. Let's consider ua and ub. Okay, so it will be having a velocity. So this ball are rolling. Okay. See, this ball A is rolling to the right side and MB is also rolling to the left side. Okay. Now we have to consider a case in which UA is greater than UB. The meaning of this is the velocity of this ball is greater than the second ball. A ball is greater than second ball. A ball ki velocity B wali velocity se zyada hai. Isliye ye isse takrane wali hai. तो सेकंड केस में आप देख सकते हो कि यहाँ पे ये दोनों बॉल है वो एक दूसरे के साथ कोलाइड हो गए हैं. आप देख सकते हो कि ये दोनों एक दूसरे के साथ कोलाइड हो गए हैं, स्ट्राइक हो गए. तो कोलाइड हुए तो क्या हुआ? न्यूटन का थर्ड लॉ है वो पिक्चर में आता है. आप देखिए, ए ने बी के ऊपर एक फोर्स लगाया. कौन सा वाला? पुश फोर्स. तो बी ने ए के ऊपर सामने एक फोर्स लगाया. कौन सा फोर्स? पुल फोर्स. ठीक है, या फिर आप इसको कंसीडर कीजिए, ये एक्शन वाला फोर्स है वो ए ने बी के ऊपर लगाया और रिएक्शन वाला फोर्स था वो बी ने ए के ऊपर लगाया है. ठीक है, उसके बाद क्या हुआ? ये दोनों बॉल है वो सेपरेट हो जाएंगे ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन में. तो दोनों सेपरेट हो गए. जब ए सेपरेट हुआ उसकी वेलोसिटी वी ए है, और जब बी सेपरेट हुआ तो वी बी है. और मैंने मेंशन किया है कि यू ए और यू बी इनिशियल वेलोसिटी है फॉर बॉल ए और बॉल बी. सेम वे वी ए और वी बी है वो भी फाइनल वेलोसिटी है फॉर बॉल ए एंड बॉल बी. Now let us try and derive law of conservation of momentum using all these diagrams and reasons. Okay, so let's start. So you have to remember one equation, that force is directly proportional to change of momentum upon given time. Okay, now let us consider this force AB. See, so force applied on B with respect to ball A, means force applied on ball B with respect to ball A. मतलब A ने B के ऊपर force लगाया, वो कैसा होगा? We will use this equation. So it is nothing but change of momentum. What was change of momentum? It was nothing but m into v minus u divided by p. So same way, if you consider that this force is applied from A to B, right? So mass will be ma, because A is applying force to B. That's why we'll consider or we'll take mass as ma. Then in bracket I will write final velocity of force ball A and initial velocity of ball A, and whole divided by p. Okay, clear? So this is a force applied on B due to A. Now let us consider another force. Force applied on ball A with respect to ball B. So what will be this force? That is FBA, because B is applying force on A. So we will rewrite the same equation as we have written for FAB. That is MB VB minus UB divided by T. Okay, now this thing is clear. Now the question comes that how to derive this law of conservation of momentum. See, we have considered the equation of force, or we have used the equation of force. Now we will use the same result. Now see, if you consider, if push action is in a positive way, then pull action will be in a negative way. Or if you consider that push action, push is an action in a positive direction, then pull will be action in a negative direction. What it means to say, I will just rub this figure and I will try to prove. What it means to say is, FAB will be nothing but equal to minus FP. FAB, it is nothing but equal to minus FPA. Because you remember, if you remember, FAB is the force that is applied in this direction and FBA is the force in opposite direction. That's why the direction is negative. That's why I have taken negative sign over here. Now I will just substitute these two equations over here. So first I will substitute FAB, that is given over here. So what is the value? That is MA VA minus UA whole divided by T, that is equal to FBA. What is FBA? Minus of MB VB minus UB whole divided by T. Now TT will be cancelled out from the denominator. Now we will multiply each and every terms. MA VA minus MA UA, it is nothing but equal to minus MB UB, sorry VB, plus MB UB. Okay, now in the next step, I will rearrange final velocity together. So, see, these are the final velocities terms. So, MA VA plus MB VB, it is nothing but equal to MA UA plus MB UB. So, what does it give us? What is this momentum? Can you tell me? As you all know, the momentum formula is M into V. So this is your final momentum. That is nothing but equal to, what is this momentum? This is your initial momentum, that is PI. What is PF over here? I am writing PF is nothing but your final momentum. That is represented over here as M cross V. In M cross V form for both the balls, okay? And initial momentum is I. Initial momentum is represented as M into U. Okay, so here, see, whatever was the initial momentum that was applied on the ball A to B, that is same as the momentum that is applied from B to A. So that gives us an idea that no loss of velocity is involved over here. As the mass is constant, so momentum is conserved. मोमेंटम है वो कंजर्व हुआ, इसलिए तो हमें ये इक्वेशन मिला कि भाई जो फाइनल मोमेंटम हमें मिला है वो कितने के इसके बराबर है, वो इनिशियल मोमेंटम के बराबर है. ठीक है, सो हियर द वीडियो एंड्स फॉर द डेरिवेशन ऑफ लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन 3 मार्क्स. सो होप यू ऑल हैव एंजॉयड द वीडियो. सो डू लाइक द वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो.